Hi, boys and girls. Today we're going to continue listening to The Carnival of the Animals by composer Camille Saint-Saëns. He was a French composer who lived well over 100 years ago. And the book that I'm going to be reading excerpts from is by Barry Carson Turner. So we're going to review what we did last time. We listened to The March of the Lion. So we're going to listen to that again, and then we're going to listen to one other piece today. And I'm not going to tell you what it is, because I want you to see if you can figure out what animal that is when we get to it. So let me read to you about the Royal March of the Lion. Listen. The orchestra is calling our attention. The music begins, and it gets louder and louder. Who is arriving? It's the lion! The strings are playing the lion's marching tune as he walks proudly around his kingdom. Sometimes he roars loudly. Can you hear the pianos playing the lion's roar? Do you think the other animals are afraid of him? I don't know. Now the music grows quiet as the lion pauses for a moment to watch over his kingdom. Then he roars again, one final time, before he strides off. So there's a picture of the lion. And here's my picture of the lion. Oh, right there. So we're going to listen to the Royal March of the Lion. Now remember what I said last time. The orchestra starts and there's a long introduction because they are announcing the lion. He makes a really grand entrance and then he appears. So once he appears, and I'll point that out in the beginning, we're going to count with our fingers how many times we hear him roar. So that's the orchestra, and they are announcing the lion. He hasn't come out yet. Hope you were counting. There are a couple little roars in the strings in there. All right, so now we're going to listen to one other piece of music. I'm going to show you two pictures of an animal, and you're going to try to figure out which one it is. So obviously, it's not going to be the lion because we already listened to the lion. So your two choices are either the turtle or the hens and roosters. So think about each of these animals. Which one do you think it's going to be when I play the music? So the hens and roosters, think about what these animals look like and sound like. So roosters, what do they say? Cock-a-doodle-doo! So you might want to listen for occasional cock-a-doodle-doo, or what about a hen, a chicken? They go bawk, 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 and they peck at the ground when they eat. So listen for maybe if it's this one, listen for pecking or cock-a-doodle-doos or little chicken sounds. You think it's the turtle. Let's think about how the turtle moves, because I don't really know what a turtle sounds like so much. But how does a turtle move? Are they fast? Are they slow? Do they run? Do they creep? They're slow. So think if the music is slow, maybe it's the turtle. Or if it's... So it would probably not be very fast, this music, when it's the turtle. All right, so let's listen. I'm going to try to hold these up. You can see that, and I'm going to play the music. Don't say what it is until the end, and then I'm going to ask what you think it is. Did you think it was? Was it really slow, like a turtle the whole time, walking or dancing? Or was it, or did you hear any cock-a-doodle-doo or pecking hens? Which one did you think it was? Well, if you said the hens and the roosters, you were correct. We're going to listen to it one more time. It's a very short piece of music. And I'll try to post in the description a link to a video with this recording, or with a recording of it, so that you can hear it better, because I don't think the quality that you hear is going to be as good. So you can listen to the recording of down below to get a better idea of what it sounds like. So let me read this to you, and then I'm going to play it one more time. So here's the hens and roosters. The hens' music is played by the violin and viola. They play a spiky, jumpy tune, which sounds just like hens scratching around, clucking and squawking to each other. Can you hear the high trills? Excuse me. Can you hear the high trills on the piano? That's the rooster. Look at me, look at me, he seems to cry. The rooster wants the hens to stop their clucking and admire him, but the hens take no notice. Now the clarinet plays the part of the rooster. There's the clarinet. But you can hardly hear him above the noise as the hens carry on scratching and clucking. Do you think the poor rooster will ever make himself heard? That poor rooster. So we're going to listen to the cock-a-doodle-doos first in the piano, and then it's going to come in the clarinet later on. And then you're going to hear the hens get louder and louder with their clucking and their pecking at the food. So let's listen to that one more time. We're going to count the cock-a-doodle-doos. There's the hens pecking. Let's peck like hens. There's the piano playing cock-a-doodle-doo. There's a second cock-a-doodle-doo. They're pecking again. There's the clarinet, the third cock-a-doodle-doo. And they keep pecking and pecking, they're ignoring that rooster. They're getting faster and faster. Look at those hens. All right, so I'm going to post down below a better recording for you to hear it. All right, till next time, boys and girls.